In December 2021, China complained to the United Nations, saying it had to conduct evasive maneuvers of its space station to avoid potential collision with two Starlink satellites. In the same month, the Indian government issued a notice to the newly registered Starlink India Private Limited to stop taking registration for its beta launch and apply for a commercial license. But Starlink is a project of the iconic American entrepreneur Elon Musk, who started very innovative and successful companies like Tesla, SpaceX, etc. is considered the next Henry Ford of America. So what is it about Starlink that spooks governments around the world? And what exactly is Starlink? Starlink is a satellite internet constellation operated by SpaceX, providing satellite internet access coverage to 32 countries. It aims for global coverage. As of May 2022, Starlink consists of over 2,400 mass-produced small satellites in low Earth orbit, which communicate with the designated ground receivers. Today, the worldwide internet network is achieved by fiber optic undersea cables. This huge network is spread all across the globe. Once over land, the respective internet service provider would then distribute it to the consumers all across the country. The problem with this type of distribution is the cost. It needs a great deal of capital to lay thousands of miles of fiber optic cables all throughout the country. Since it is a capital-intensive business, the affordability of a high-speed internet connection is also questionable, especially in developing countries like India, where the average speed of broadband connection is only 6 Mbps. High-speed broadband connectivity becomes challenging in hilly terrains and remote locations. While internet connectivity achieved by wireless transmission is prone to bad weather, broadband undersea internet connectivity is, however, not safe and can be spied upon. In 1970, the US government launched a top-secret mission called Operation Ivy Bells to tap undersea communications cable of the Soviet Navy in the Sea of Okhotsk, which connected the major Soviet naval base at Petropavlovsk on the Kamchatka Peninsula to the Soviet Pacific Fleet's mainland headquarters at Vladivostok. The area was heavily defended. The Sea of Okhotsk was claimed by the Soviet Union as territorial waters and was strictly off-limits to foreign vessels. The Soviet Navy had installed a network of sound detection devices all along the seabed to detect intruders. In spite of this heavy security, in October 1971, the United States sent a purpose-built modified submarine, USS Halliburton, deep into the Sea of Okhotsk. The US Navy divers working from Halliburton found the cable at 400 feet of water and installed a 20-foot-long device, which wrapped around the cable without piercing its casing and recorded all communications made over it. The large recording device was designed to detect if the cable was raised for repair. The recordings of the tapings were then delivered to the NSA for processing and dissemination to other US intelligence agencies. The first tapes recorded revealed that the Soviets were so sure of the cable's security that the majority of the conversations made over it were unencrypted. The eavesdropping on the traffic between the senior Soviet officers provided valuable information on naval operations at Petropavlovsk, the Pacific Fleet's primary nuclear submarine base, home to the Yankee and Delta-class nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines. This operation went on undetected for 10 years until a CIA agent exposed the details of the operation to the KGB. This episode reveals the vulnerability of the undersea cables to espionage. Satellite internet access is provided by communication satellites. Communication satellites launched at 35,785 kilometers are geostationary satellites, and their orbit is called medium Earth orbit. Due to the distance, the MEO satellites have a wide coverage, and hence lesser number of satellites are required to cover the globe. For this reason, as of 1st January 2021, there are only 2,224 communication satellites in medium Earth orbit. But due to the distance, the MEO satellites require more power for signal transmission and amplification, and also the signal strength is weak with high latency. MEO satellites are used for low-intensity work like GPS coverage and communications to cover the North and South Pole. O3b satellite constellation, operated by the SES Networks, is the only company in this orbit operating around 20 satellites at Ka band frequency, providing internet access to remote locations. For faster internet access, low Earth orbit is used, which is at a maximum distance of 2,000 km from the Earth's surface. A low Earth orbit requires the lowest amount of energy for the satellite's placement. It provides high bandwidth and low communication latency. Satellites and space stations in the LEO are more accessible to crew and servicing. It requires less energy to place a satellite into an LEO and less powerful amplifiers for successful transmission. Low Earth orbit is the place where most of the space activity takes place. The International Space Station and the Chinese Tiangong Space Station is in the low Earth orbit of about 400 and 450 kilometers respectively from the Earth's surface. The Hubble Space Telescope orbits at about 540 kilometers from the Earth. All remote sensing satellites, including spy satellites and Earth imaging satellites, use LEO as they are able to see the surface of the Earth more clearly by being closer to it. But one big problem with the LEO satellite is its small area of coverage. For this reason, many satellites have to be launched to achieve global coverage. Presently, Iridium Satellite Constellation and Globestar are the two companies involved in providing global internet access. Iridium Satellite Constellation operates 66 satellites at L-band and Ka-band, giving both internet access and satellite telephony. Globalstar Satellite Constellation operates 48 satellites, also providing both internet access and satellite telephony. But these two systems are very old. The internet bandwidth and the internet speed of both these systems are low. And hence, to exploit this market gap for a high-speed internet, Starlink was created. Starlink is a subsidiary of SpaceX, founded and run by Elon Musk. Right from the beginning, Starlink was a great idea. It tended to solve many problems related to satellite internet access. Starlink's business potential was phenomenal. SpaceX expects more than $30 billion US in revenue by 2025 from Starlink. That is 15 times more than SpaceX standalone revenue of $2 billion US. It's because of this big business prospect, Jeff Bezos launched Kuiper Systems, which will have 3,276 satellites. In addition to its commercial prospects, Starlink also drew the US military attention as it tended to solve many of their problems. The military funding provided to Starlink would later prove to be crucial. Starlink was publicly announced in January 2015 at the opening of the SpaceX Satellite Development Facility in Redmond, Washington. SpaceX estimated the total investment for the entire project to be $10 billion US. By November 2018, SpaceX received the FCC approval to launch 12,000 satellites to the orbit. SpaceX would launch the initial 12,000 satellites to orbit in three orbital shells. The first shell would consist of 1,440 satellites at an altitude of 550 kilometers. The second shell would consist of 2,825 Ku band and Ka band spectrum satellites at an altitude of 1,110 kilometers. The third shell would consist of 7,500 V band satellites at an altitude of 340 kilometers. In total, nearly 12,000 satellites were planned to be deployed, with a possible later extension to 42,000 satellites. On 23rd May 2019, SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket lifted from Cape Canaveral, Florida, carrying the first 60 satellites of the Starlink network. By May 2019, 2,400 of the satellites were deployed in lower Earth orbit and Starlink became operational. But Starlink from the very beginning was closely related to the military. In March 2018, a new organization called Space Development Agency was formed by the US government, and it was headed by the Undersecretary of Defense, Michael D. Griffin. Griffin was instrumental in forming SpaceX and was a close associate of Elon Musk. In October 2020, the Space Development Agency awarded SpaceX an initial $150 million US to develop a deluxe military version of the Starlink satellite bus. This military version of the Starlink would mirror the concepts of the now canceled but feared Cold War era Brilliant Pebble system. In the Brilliant Pebble system, actively pursued in the late 80s, the US would launch thousands of small satellites which would be placed in orbits so that hundreds would be above the Soviet Union at all times. If the Soviets launched their ICBMs, the Pebbles would detect their rocket motor exhaust using infrared seekers and collide with them. The system would consist of 10,000 small missiles. If the Soviets wanted to destroy the Pebbles, they would have to take out all the 10,000 missiles. This project was later cancelled as the USSR collapsed. Starlink network would eventually contain 42,000 satellites, which is quite frightening. If the Starlink becomes operational with all these 42,000 satellites, then a truly innovative method is needed to take out all these satellites. In 2019, tests by the United States Air Force Research Laboratory demonstrated a 610 megabits data link through Starlink to a Beechcraft C-12 Huron aircraft in flight. Additionally, in late 2019, the United States Air Force successfully tested the connection with Starlink on AC-130 gunship. According to China, Starlink can be programmed to track hypersonic missiles, dramatically boost the data transmission speeds of US drones and stealth fighter jets, or even ram into and destroy Chinese satellites. China had some near misses with the Starlink satellites already, having returned to the UN last year to complain that the country's space station was forced to perform emergency maneuvers to avoid close encounters with the Starlink satellites in July and October 2021. China's countermeasures to the Starlink satellites will be microwave jammers that can disrupt communications or fry electrical components, powerful millimeter resolution lasers that can blind satellite sensors, cyber weapons to hack into satellite networks, and long-range anti-satellite missiles, or ASAT, to destroy them. The ASAT to destroy so many satellites would have to be nuclear. In the 2022 Ukraine war, Russia attacked Starlink by jamming its satellite signals. Elon Musk has provided 5,000 Starlink sets to Ukraine. The Starlink constellation constitutes a decentralized system. The whole confrontation is not about individual satellites, but the whole system. China may be looking at alternative ways to counter Starlink because ASAT missiles create hazardous conditions for all nations operating in space. Space shrapnel has a potential to cause serious damage to satellites. In October 2021, Chinese scientists claim to have designed a way to avoid Debus problem with an explosive device that could be packed inside a satellite's exhaust nozzle, safely blowing up the satellite without making any mess, and in a way that could be mistaken for an engine malfunction. India stopped Starlink primarily due to concern that it was unregulated, and also it's not clear what market Starlink is tapping in India. Starlink India CEO Sanjay Bhargava said that Starlink wanted to participate in Indian government vision of 100% internet coverage. But its pricing in India tells a different story. Starlink's pricing in India is the same as in the US. It has a setup cost of $600 and a monthly subscription of $99, with a maximum speed offered as 150 Mbps. Whereas any local broadband connection has zero installation cost and $19 of monthly subscription for internet speed of 300 Mbps. So Starlink seemed to have a different vision of India, maybe. Also, India has many other players like OneWeb and Kuiper Systems already in the fray. It remains to be seen how Starlink fares up to the competition and will it serve India's needs. If you like this video, please subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.